Good afternoon, everyone. My name is AB. I am from CDAC. I am here to present a rural health management information system using mobile phones. The main objective of this project is strengthening healthcare activities at grassroots level for synthesizing healthcare management. It is the first time in India that's a comprehensive application which have all the health data collected from the field. And we won the EVAL 2011 award for the second best mHealth project for in public voting category. The RHMS has a software called mCare. This software contains two major components. One is a standalone mobile application, which used to collect data from the field and their follow-ups. And the second one is centrally host a web application, which related analysis purpose and report generation, which is accessible by the higher authorities. And this project was implemented in Tirur Taluk, a rural area of Malappuram district in Kerala, in 2009, which covers 7.2 lakhs of population in three blocks that contain 20 health blocks, like it contains CHC, community health center, block primary health centers, and primary health centers, namely Vettam block, Valavannur, and Kuttipuram. The mainly services is done at 119 sub-centers, and the centrally hosted application is deployed in Kerala State Data Center. And why we need this application? And when we notice that in rural area, the health worker, for half of the day they spend for the data collection from household. And the next afternoon they come to their office and they have to prepare 7 to 8 reports. And they have to write in manually. And this reports contains written that same data they have to place in different reports. And increase the size of the subcenter may be more, and the population is large, and government want to introduce new schemes into the subcenters, so they have to collect that data also from the field. So this this leads to increase the workload of the health worker, and the manually collected data is purely. There is no information technology is used, that's why it's pure quality. And they have to spend more time for clerical duties than the field work. And this leads, there is no information technology is used, the communication is not there. That is why the poor quality of data that is collected from the field and inadequate reporting. That is why we developed this software. And our implementation methodology was, this was to develop, implemented in pilotly base, and this reduced the time and the cost also. And we are choosing Kerala as a test bed for this pilot implementation. And this software is scalable for scalable, and we are sharing the existing resources that are already there, that like Kerala State Wide Area Network is there in ICT project is there in Kerala. So we have taken that as a communication purpose. And after this pilot implementation, we have undergone an impact study for the impact of this project on public and on health worker. The main services we have offered in through this software is family health survey, immigration and migration, eligible couples, data collection, and family different family planning methods and their follow-ups, and immunization, antenatal care and postnatal care, and disease surveillance. This includes both communicable disease and non-communicable disease, and the village survey, and the main reports that are used in the health worker. And this RNCP is a revised national tuberculosis program and vector study. This is for mosquito controlling program. And this software facilitates data collection and dissemination from the field data. And we are providing name-based tracking and their follow-ups. And the software supports health worker to collect data from the field. The main feature of this one, accurate and relevant up-to-date health data, and primary wide coverage of healthcare service, and centrally hosted repository for health services, and early identification of antenatal care high-risk cases, and they provide schedule of service and work plan. And this main point is the it eliminates the burden of manual record keeping. And it supports national programs, national health programs, and it's timely, accurate, and reports. And immunization alerts and ANC alerts are we are providing. And individual-based follow-ups are there, and statistical analysis, and some graphical reports are there. This is the main architecture of that software. The health worker usually collects the data from using that smartphone, and they sync that data into the public health center or CSC, and that centrally hosted application can be accessed from that district health service or district office. The technologies we have used is Java, and it's MEC architecture and struts, and we are using open source versions. In mobile phone based application, we have used in Java based application that runs on smartphone, in Windows smartphone. And the database we have used is HSQLDB. And the enhanced version of this application is in posted into Android platform also. And what are the main things that mother care and child care we have done? By the use of name-based tracking system, we can deliver the proper service to pregnant women, antenatal registration that collects name, date of birth, LMP, and order of pregnancy, if number of children, and which trimester it registered. And the following follow-ups contains weight, HP, and TT, and IFIN tablets that we have produced. And if there is any high-risk pregnancy cases, like anemia or BP more than 140, it's pregnancy below 20 and above 30. And we are also collected the ANC termination details, the type of termination. It will be a MTP or abortion, and what is the reason for that MTP abortion, and the type of delivery and the delivery outcome, and date of delivery, infant details, and any complication like bleeding and other, if anything is there, that is also collected. Then postpartum care. After delivery, we will conduct the postpartum care, and the date of visit and complications, if any is there for child and mother, and we are capturing that also. For the immunization, the child registration and weight of the child and child conditions up to 28 days, these details are we have collected. And immunization, there are central government has fixed scheduled immunization and other immunization if any complication is there, and that also we have captured. The software helps to reduce maternal mortality rate by regular checkup of pregnant women, which helps to early identification of high-risk cases, and offering information and advice to the pregnant woman about pregnancy-related complication, that helps to measure the early detection. And we are collecting all the data in antenatal pregnant women, irrespective of private or public, and whether it is from private hospitals also, the health worker is collecting these details. And we are providing alerts to any due cases are there. The health worker can identify if any antenatal care due cases are there. They can make actions against that one. And the child care model helps to reduce infant mortality by improving immunization rate. We are collecting all the immunizations, so whether it is from private or in the PSC. And if any due immunization is there, and we have alert the health worker and the parents also, so they can have the immunization and perfectly done. And what impact on RHMS in health worker? Health worker saves lots of time, and this is a only one-time data entry from the field, and all the reports are maintained automatically. So they save the time, data collection, and the report generation, and improve healthcare delivery, and in efficiency in disease surveillance, and early identification of high-risk cases. In other higher officials and the government agencies, the accurate and up-to-date data from the lower levels, and the efficiency attained for a decision-making process, and efficiency attained for supervisory control, that they have accurately and up-to-date reports. From that, they know the details of all the antenatal and child immunizations and other details also. And this can be used, this information can be used various national programs and population survey, researches, and census. And what the impact of public? It improves the overall quality and coverage of healthcare services received by the public, and decreasing the rate of maternal death and infant mortality. By the health workers, reduce the workload, that leads to improved healthcare delivery in various scenarios, that like they can provide awareness of family planning methods and address more antenatal cases in the field, and improve the quality and quantity of postpartum care, and awareness the public about the immunization. That's why some videos or something like, and this way improve the immunization rate. And they conduct some education class, community education class, like family welfare or antenatal care and immunization. And epidemics can be controlled for the proper follow-ups of awareness program. It saves time for the public, because the recurring survey, each year, the health worker has to conduct a survey and update the family health register. By the use of this software, they can only update the just updations only. That's why it's reduced the time of the public also. And this is the impact analysis that IMCARE and that our solution and the manual system. It slightly reduce the workload and training and awareness. You can see the various details. Personal satisfaction, high availability of reports, and consolidation of reports to the higher levels, and report generation at sub-center, data entry and data collection, and data finding and searching and editing information through the system. This is the population details that what we have collected in that 77.2 lakhs. And it's around 3 lakh male adults category, male, and the children's and females categories are there, senior citizen, and there is a caste-based population also we have presented. This is the feedback of end user, that health worker feedback of this system. It's scale of 1 to 10 actually. Okay, this is the software, some screenshot of that software, and we are providing graphical reports so that the higher officials can take decisions from this data collector. And this is some sample photos of that in field work. The second photo is the smartphone which load our application. So, any questions? Yeah. Yeah, smartphones.
Server is fairly quick and simplistic. My question is, have you tried using basic phones? I understand that the questions are very binary. There would be yes, nor answers, because more than that is not possible to capture on a mobile phone, right?
Yeah.
So what is the kind of, have you had any experience in using basic phones? And I will also request some of our other case presenters and experiences from DEF to share if this is possible to do outside a smartphone.
Yeah, but this the health worker do a large survey, and it contains more information. In by the use of that the basic phone, we have only collect the consolidated values only, just one, if how many anti-decanator cases are there, so that we can type on the mobile phones, it's toll or something like that. The individual details will be more difficult in basic phone, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, we have provided three blocks actually, three health blocks only. This is a pilot implementation project. We have all the health worker, we have given the health mobile phones. And they are used to collect details.
So if they have own mobile phone?
No, no, no. We are providing, we are providing the smartphone to health worker, and they used to collect the health info, health data from by using this smartphone. It's a one-time survey. One-time survey. All the reports. Instead of writing the phone, actually, in phone they have to only one-time entry is there. The if we visit the house call, we will they have the it's uploaded in the phone. Actually, it's contain household details like how what type of house is there. It like terrace or thatched, or whether any sanitation is provided or not, or any like that. All the details are there. The health worker can, all details are selection based, so that health worker can select minimum data entry. That's
own language, or
Now we are providing in English in Android. We are enhanced the version Android that supports the local language.
Somewhere along the line, this is possible to do even on a basic phone. We have examples from Jharkhand where they have done it on a basic phone. It's basic data. In even in Kaushambi, Bihar, Kaushambi, UP, they have used the basic phones, the one that we were showing you. And somewhere along the line, this, the idea is that you can do something similar. It can be, if it's more complicated, you use an Android phone. If you keep it simple, you can use a basic phone also. But the thought was to plant the idea that you can track both things. You can track the woman through the health frontline worker, and you can also give an alert to the health frontline worker about the women in her catchment that she needs to revisit. And you can also give her the device which will allow her to start a conversation with that woman at that point in time. So once you've done the basic data collection of the universe, you will then identify who are the antenatal women, and you can then go back to those antenatal women and start the conversation through the ASHA worker. And that alert that I need to go back can come to you via an SMS. So it's the idea is that you can map your entire universe of the catchment or the participants or the beneficiaries, and then depending on their age profile and the need, you can go back to them. And your entire paper-based data collection can become simpler, and once you feed it, it goes into the server. So then it's sorted. Then you don't have to feed it again and again. After that, it's an updation. That's the basic understanding. But we will have DEF also present to you very briefly about what is happening in Jharkhand, where they have used the other phones, the basic phones. There was one more question?
Yeah.
Two, one, two, three. Yeah.
I wanted to know about the connectivity requirements. Can the data be uploaded when the system is offline, or is there the connectivity issues there?
No, actually we have only offline data collections only. When it comes to PAC, it will automatically sync to the server.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
You need to have internet connectivity when you're
collecting
the data.
How is the data transfer to main system? You were collecting the survey from the mobile
phone, after collecting the data from the field, the mobile connected to the computer in PAC, and our application fetches the updated data from the mobile and it loads sync to the server.
Okay, this is
thank you.
Sorry, this is not. This is more of a comment than a question. I just wanted to, throw another angle to this discussion of basic phones versus, high-end phones.
Okay.
And I'm going to make this comment based on an assumption. See, wherever health-related data is being captured or wherever monitoring is happening, I'll go with the assumption that there is an efficient Asha or an ANM or an Anganwadi worker there in place. And for her to function well, she needs the confidence of her community around her. And the NRHM has mandated various committees at different levels. And assuming that these committees are functioning, why can't, and there are so many untied funds which are released to the primary health center and the sub-centers. Each sub-center gets about 20,000 rupees. Primary health centers in Karnataka get 1,75,000 rupees a year. If the committee or the community is convinced that using these mobile devices, high-end mobile devices, is going to get them a lot of good content, I mean, these funds can be used to buy these devices, so they become a collective property. This angle can maybe explored with say people who are working with committees or communities. Yeah, I can understand. I can there are some very obvious questions.
And I think we shouldn't pose the easiest fix, which is buy a device. That's not the issue. The issue is the device can help. It can be any device. My personal view on this is that the device is a possibility, but not the only thing. There are many, even with the device, in whatever way I have used mobile phones in very small space, there is a lot of hand-holding required, even with that device, as with any other system. So it's the design of the system which is more important than the device.
Yeah, of course. That's why I started with saying that this is an assumption where communication among the community and the training and the hand-holding is working
all
well.
All going very well. Yeah. Then you can go in for your device. Yeah. Osama, you wanted to say something?
My question is, what is the average duration to collect per household using the software?
Okay.
The duration for the data you are collecting, right? What is the duration per household I am asking about? Not whole.
Okay.
Per household, example, average.
Per house.
How much time?
That depends upon the service given to that particular house. If one service is there, it is around 5 to 10 minutes. That's it.
Like you showed something 14 or 15 soft headings like sanitary or something regular.
Yeah.
I'm taking average. I'm asking average.
Average about our data and data collection.
Yeah.
Around households of 30 to 40 per day. We can household, we discuss the 30 to 40 households per day, actually.
I'm not asking the households, duration per household, how much the time the software need to enter the data?
10 to 20 minutes. 10 to 20 minutes.
Thank
if the because the house call, the name, and all the people's names in that particular house is inside the system. So they have to just give the or add the service to the that current person.
Okay, that's why it is a symbol.
Thank you.
Okay.
Does your system sync online, like if somebody is surveying at one house or village?
Okay.
Can it?
Actually, we have enhanced version in Android. In that version, we have online synchronization provide. It sync when if the internet connection is available, that time it will sync to the central server.
And also this data, are you cross-checking with any other kind of parameter like ration card or Aadhaar card or something like that, or it is all individual data?
No, we were collecting also the both ration card and Aadhaar card. If it is there, and the health worker can also add that details also.